Welcome to the session. In this session, we will discuss about touching or tangent circles and common tangents. If the two circles touch each other, at a single point, the circles are touching or tangent circles. Also, we say that two circles are tangent if they are tangent to the same line at the same point. As you can see, these two circles with centers O and O dash touch each other at a single point P. So they are the tangent circles, or you can say touching circles. Also, we observe from the figure that these two circles are tangent to the same line ST and at the same point P. So they are the tangent or touching circles. A line tangent to each of the two circles is called a common tangent to two circles. Like in this figure, line ST is tangent to each of the two circles with centers O and O dash. So, ST is the common tangent to the two circles. Next we have, if the two circles lie on the same side of the common tangent, then the common tangent is called an exterior, or you can say direct common tangent. Like in this figure, we have two intersecting circles, and these are the two common tangents to the two circles. As you can see, the two circles lie on the same side of the common tangent, and so these two common tangents are the exterior or direct common tangents. The next we have, if the two circles lie on the opposite side of the common tangent, then the common tangent called an interior or transverse common tangent. Consider this figure in which we have the two circles which do not intersect each other. In this case, as you can see, there are four tangents to both the circles. Now, these two tangents are the exterior common tangents, as the two circles lie on the same side of these tangents. And if you consider these two tangents, then you can see that the two circles lie on the opposite side of the common tangents, and so these tangents are the interior common tangents, or you can say transverse tangents. Next, let's discuss internally tangent circles. If the centers of two coplanar circles are on the same side of their common tangent, the circles are internally tangent circles. Consider this figure. In this, we have two coplanar circles in which the centers of the two circles are on the same side of their common tangent. The common tangent to the two circles is at the point P. So these are the internally tangent circles. Now, for internally tangent circles, there is only one line tangent to both the circles. Consider the radius of this bigger circle, that is O dash P, be equal to R1, and the radius of the smaller circle, that is OP, be equal to R2. Then if D be the distance between the centers of the two circles, that is OO dash, then this would be equal to radius of the bigger circle, that is O dash P, which is R1, minus the radius of the smaller circle, which is OP, and that is R2. So, when the two circles touch each other internally, then the distance between these centers is the difference of their radii. Next, we will discuss externally tangent circles. If the centers of two coplanar circles are on the opposite sides of the common tangent, then the circles are called externally tangent circles. If you observe this figure, you find that the centers of these two circles are on the opposite sides of their common tangents. And so, they are the externally tangent circles. Now, for externally tangent circles, there are three lines tangent to both circles. So from this figure also we observe that there are three lines tangent to both the circles. This line is also tangent to these two circles. This line is also a tangent to these two circles. And even this line is also a tangent to these two circles. Now suppose the radius of this circle with center O dash dr1, that is we have O dash P is equal to R1, radius of this circle with center O dr2, so we have OP is equal to R2, then the distance D between the centers of the two circles, that is OO dash is equal to R1 plus R2. So if the two circles touch each other externally, then the distance between their centers is the sum of their radii. We've already seen that if the two circles intersect each other, then there would be only two lines tangent to both these circles, and in this case these two lines would be called exterior common tangents. And when the two circles do not intersect each other, then there would be four lines tangent to both the circles. In that case, these two would be exterior common tangents and these two would be interior common tangents. Now let's see how many tangents are there if one circle is contained in the interior of another. So when we look at this figure in which one circle with center O is contained in another circle with center O dash, then we find that there is no line tangent to both the circles. Now we'll discuss one theorem which states that if two circles touch each other the point of contact lies on the straight line joining the centers of two circles. So, we are given two circles with centers O and O dash, and they touch each other at point P. So we will take two cases when the two circles touch each other externally, which is shown by figure 1, and when the two circles touch each other internally, shown in figure 2. According to the theorem, we have to prove that the point of contact of the two circles lies on the straight line joining the centers of the two circles. So to prove that the point P lies on the straight line through the centers of the two circles, that is O and O dash. And we have also drawn the common tangent PT to the two circles. We have joined the centers of the two circles with the point of contact of the two circles. Let us now start with the proof. Now we know that the tangent and the radius through the point of contact are perpendicular to each other. That is, this tangent PT in both these figures is perpendicular to the radius of the two circles, that is OP is perpendicular to PT and O dash P is perpendicular to PT in both the cases. So this means from the figure angle OPT is equal to 90 degrees and angle O dash PT is also equal to 90 degrees. So we have got these angles of measure 90 degrees. Now consider the figure 1. So in figure 1, when the two circles touch each other externally, we have angle OPT plus angle O dash PT this would be equal to 90 degrees plus 90 degrees which is equal to 180 degrees. Now as these two angles form a linear pair, so this means OP O dash is a straight line. Thus we get OP O dash is a straight line when the two circles touch each other externally. Now we consider the case when the two circles touch each other internally. In this, that is in figure 2, we have angle OPT is equal to angle O dash PT as each is equal to 90 degrees. So this means that O dash P lies along OP. Now, when the two circles touch each other internally, then also we find that O dash P lies along OP. This also means that P lies on the straight line through O and O dash. Hence, we can say that when the two circles touch each other internally or externally, then the point P lies on the straight line through O and O dash. So this is what we were supposed to prove. Hence we have proved the given theorem. So this completes the session. Hope you have understood the topic of touching of tangent circles and common tangents.